in one day for a round. He'd have to come in full Alice gear, though.
Yeah, of course he would.
He's a good golfer.
This day, 1968, at EMI Studios in London, the Beatles' record Across the Universe was being made. John Lennon and Paul McCartney decide the song needs some falsetto harmonies. So they invited two waiting girl fans, Lizzie Bravo, a 16-year-old Brazilian person living nearby, and 17-year-old Londoner Gaylene Peace into the studio to sing on the song.
Oh, wow, that was their lucky day, wasn't it?
We'd like you to sing on the Beatles hit, please.
Amazing.
That's brilliant. Great. And this year, 2000, who confirms that a particular band have turned down £1 million, or dollars it might be, an offer by a British and American consortium to reform? Who was the singer, songwriter, and what was the name of the band?
ABBA?
Yes.
Oh, well done. Yeah. Where did that come from?
Well, I think it might have been EMI or something like that. That's great. Charles Lindbergh, who was that then, Janie?
Was it the first solo flight?
Yes, it was.
Who was that?
Charles Lindbergh, 1902 this day. American aviator who made the first solo flight over the Atlantic.
Yeah, didn't do it in 1902, though.
No, that's when he was born.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
What year was it?
Well, that's a good question. Yeah. I don't know.
30s, I think.
Yeah, 30s. Losing interest. Timmy Mallet.
You started it.
I know. And Jack Monroe with us later. Budapest. Love to hear from you. Email steve.wright@bbc.co.uk, text 88291, tweet us at BBC Radio 2. When we come back, after the news, Tracy Ann Hutchinson from Norwich, picking the non-stop oldies.
This is Jane Royce. An independent inquiry into a surgeon who performed botched or unnecessary breast operations in the West Midlands has found his patients were let down over many years by numerous failures in the health service. Ian Patterson is currently serving 20 years for wounding. The report described his actions as callous and wicked and made 15 recommendations, including making sure all his patients were recalled. One, Leslie Cuthbert, said she hoped action would be taken.
Mr. Patterson sort of more or less
confessed
going privately by telling me that my operations were urgently needed. And in actual fact, as I found out many years later, I didn't have cancer at all.
The Health Minister Nadine Dorries has apologised on behalf of the government and the NHS. She said they were committed to learning lessons from what had happened. The Foreign Office is recommending that all Britons leave China because of the coronavirus. It had previously warned against all but essential travel. Our correspondent in Shanghai, Robin Brandt, explains why the advice has changed.
The Foreign Office is about to try and lay on what it's called the last flight to evacuate Britons out of that city of Wuhan. And also, over the last week or so, the Foreign Office has removed non-essential staff from parts of its embassy in Beijing and also its consulates spread throughout the country. And that means there's fewer people who can help any Britons here who are in distress.
Prosecution in the murder trial of Sasha Mohammadi, the brother of the Manchester arena bomber, has told the Old Bailey that he's equally responsible for the 22 deaths. Mr. Abedi denies helping his brother Salman make a homemade explosive device and set it off outside a pop concert in 2017. Boris Johnson has declared that Britain will lead the way in tackling climate change, as he announced he was bringing forward by 5 years the date when the sale of all new petrol, diesel and hybrid cars will be banned. He was speaking at an event in London to launch a UN summit on the issue in Glasgow later this year. Car makers have questioned the plans, and Ian Plummer from the website Auto Trader says it can't become a reality.
Speed cameras.
The cost of electric cars versus petrol and diesel vehicles is addressed.
That price gap is around 25% on average, and that's a very considerable barrier to people who ultimately want to make the shift to electric vehicles, and we believe 3 in 4 of UK car buyers want to do just that. But actually, when they're looking at the reality, they
speed camera
in front of the planet.
Senior ministers have rejected a claim that the Prime Minister doesn't really get the issue of climate change. The former Energy Minister, Claire O'Neill, who was sacked by Mr. Johnson as the chair of the UN Climate Summit in Glasgow, said he lacked engagement. The V&A in Dundee has welcomed its 1 millionth visitor, a 7-year-old girl from Berlin. The Design Museum opened its doors in September 2018. And that's the BBC News at 3 minutes past 3 on Next at 4.
Thank you, Jane.
Where you look and find in the stealing.
From Norwich, picking these non-stop oldies.
Every day it's getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day it's getting faster. Everyone said go and ask her. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day seems a little longer. Every way love's a little stronger. Come what may, do you ever long for true love from me? Every day it's getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way.
In the emergency department at the Norfolk and Norwich Hospital. My love of music comes from my mum and dad, who met on the dance floor of a Greasy Spoon Cafe in Great Yarmouth during the rock and roll era of the late 50s. All of my oldies bring back wonderful memories of growing up by the seaside in the 60s and 70s, from discovering my dad's Buddy Holly collection to saving up to buy my first 45. Loud school discos where we danced on our handbags, spending days on the beach with my best mate Ange, playing our worn-out radio cassette recorder during the long, hot summers of 75 and 76. And my first live gig, AC/DC, at the iconic Tiffany's on Great Yarmouth Seafront in 1977. I know it. I hope you enjoy my oldies, Tracy Ann Hutchinson from Norwich. Oh my goodness, I haven't heard this for years either. Patti Smith, Because the Night.